Hello everyone, welcome to LimeGuru channel. In this video, we are going to cover two most important topics of Hive, which is partitioning and bucketing. So these are the two topics or concepts which are used in real-time projects also, as well as there are questions asked during interview discussions also. So I'll highly recommend everyone to go through this video for your own learning. So let's get started. Before explaining you Hive partitioning or Hive bucketing concept, let me tell you in a brief that how data is stored in Hive in the tabular format. So whenever you run your query, you get the data in a tabular format, but internally how it stores the data. So let me tell you a brief about that so that you get to know about the partitioning and bucketing concepts better. Many of you must be aware about this concept, but let me just touch upon this very briefly. I'll quickly cover how the data is kept under the storage internally when you refer your Hive table, right? So everyone must be aware that Hive internally maintains a metastore. What I mean by metastore is it is a metadata about your table information. Table metadata is maintained in metastore. So what I mean by metadata is metadata means that all your table information, like what is your table structure, what is the format of the data, what are the columns, what are the data types of the columns, every metadata about the table is maintained in metadata, and this metadata is maintained in the metastore server, which is another process running internally in Hive. So whenever you refer to any table, let's say you have a table order, so you have an e-commerce site where you are maintaining the order table. So what this order table contains, it contains all the orders booked. Let's say it contains order ID, it contains your order date, the date on which this order was placed, then you have your product name, whatever product was ordered in this particular order, and then you have the product category. So product category, it would be whether this order product belongs to electronics or it's a apparel or fashion or grocery item, whatever item it is. So that is in product category, right? So let's say you have this table and you are storing this table in Hive. So all this information about the metadata, like you have this order table and you have different columns in your order table, so this is maintained in metastore. If the metadata is maintained in metastore, then where is your actual data? So if I talk about actual data, your actual data is stored in the form of files in HDFS. So Hive is nothing, it's just a reference of HDFS files, and the mapping of the files with table name is maintained in your metastore. So metastore contains two important things. One is the information about your table, and second thing is the location of files in HDFS, right? So your files can be on any path, and the path reference is given in the metastore or metadata for your table. So whenever you are querying your data for order table, the metastore tells you that this order table is referencing to particular location in HDFS. It goes to that location and it fetches the data from that particular HDFS location. Let's assume my path is you can think of like /home/LimeGuru/order. So let's say this is the path in my HDFS directory, and this path is containing all the data related to my order. The main point is that all the data which Hive is pointing to, it is kept at some HDFS location in the format given by you while creating your table and in the path which is specified by you, right? So this is the path where your order data will go. So let's move on to the concept of partitioning now. What is partitioning? So partitioning is an important concept when you are storing your data into some path location to be used by Hive, right? So whenever you are storing some data in HDFS, which will be used by Hive for fetching the data, then partitioning is an important concept to structure your data, to organize your data, right? So let's take the same example where you are keeping your orders, which has order ID, order date, it has product name, and it has product category, right? So all of your data goes into some location. So let's say the location is slash home slash LimeGuru slash order, right? So this is the location you have given while creating your Hive table, and all the order related data will go into this location, right? So as the data grows up, your directory size will start filling up. So all the data will go into this directory and it will start filling up, and it will as you know, in HDFS there is a concept of part files. So part files will start getting created, right? So it would be starting from 0, 1, 2, 3. As your data size will grow up, there will be multiple part files which will get created, and the all your part files will be present in this directory, right? So whenever you want to fetch some data, what happens internally is, so Hive knows whenever you are fetching the data that the data is present on this location. So the search operation will be directly done on this directory, because Hive internally knows the data is in this directory. So you will see that all the part files are there in this directory inside this path, right? So whenever you perform any fetch operation, let's say you want to search the orders for a particular month. Let's say I want to search you have the order date, right? So let's say you want to search the order for a particular date, right? You have this column in your table, in your data, and you want to search for a data for a particular date, right? So what Hive will do internally is it will search the data for that particular date in all the part files, right? What is the disadvantage here is that it is going to scan all the part files, right? As the data grow huge, as the data will become larger and larger, this is going to be a performance hit in your application or in your Hive job, that whenever you are going to select any data, and if the data is growing, then the results are going to be coming to you in a slower fashion. It's going to take more time because it's going to scan more number of files. The number of files, as those will increase with time, your Hive queries are going to become slow. Your fetch operations are going to become slow because it has to scan multiple files, and all the files are present in the same directory, right? So this is a main disadvantage, that if your data grows bigger and bigger, and if you are doing a select operation or fetch operation, then the queries will become slow if you don't do partitioning on your table, right? Now, what is partitioning and how it can be helpful? So partitioning is a concept using which you can partition your data. Let's say you already know that whenever you are going to query, you are mostly going to query based on the order date. So let's say I want to fetch orders for a particular date. I want to generate some reports and I want to fetch all the orders for a particular date, right? So how partitioning can help you in that case? So you can partition your data by this column, order date. And how you can do the partitioning is, you can do partition by, so what is the syntax of create table is, like you can write create table, and then you can write your metadata like column name and data type. After that you can specify partition by, and in the partition by you can specify order date as your partition column, right? So that's it. You just need to define your column name, and you need to specify partition by providing you a column name on which you want to partition. So this is a syntax of creating a partition, but what it internally does when you do partition by on some column, so let me tell you that. So let me write down the directory path again. So it is slash home slash LimeGuru slash order, right? Now you have done partition on order date, right? Order date. as you have partitioned on order date, so whenever you are going to insert the data, so data will always have order date, right? Let's say I'm inserting the data for January 01/01 and 2018, right? Then the dates could be in the January month there would be multiple dates 02/01/2018, second for 2nd January, for 3rd January it could be for 03/01/2018, right? So whenever you are going to insert the data, the Hive will see like what date is coming into your data, right? So whatever date is creating in whatever date is coming into your data, it will create directory for that date, because you have partitioned on basis of order date. So it will create directory sub here inside this path, which would be a subdirectory. So here you will see inside the order multiple subdirectories. Now it's not going to create part files directly here. It's going to create further subdirectories. And what would be the name of subdirectories? It would be by the name of order date equal to 01/01/2018. And then there would be another subdirectory order date equal to 02/01/2018. Similarly, there will be subdirectories for all the dates because you are partitioned by order date. So these are going to be subdirectories, and inside the subdirectories you are going to get the store the data. Hive will store the data internally within these subdirectories. So all the orders for this particular date, 1st of January 2018, these are going to be stored here. So let's say this is my part file 1, this is my part file 2, this is my part file 3. So all these part files in this subdirectory for order date 1st January 2018 only contains the orders or only contains the data for this particular date. Similarly, for this particular date, it's going to store all the data. And similarly, for other subdirectories also, it is going to store the data partitioned by order date. So now you can see that your data is partitioned now. Now you will see there is a table path, and then there is a partition subdirectories for based on the order date, and then you are storing the data. So this approach helped you to organize your data. You have organized your data based on order date, because you know you are going to get fetch your data mostly based on the order date. So now what will happen when you do fetch operation based on order date? Let's say I want to fetch the orders where order date is equal to 2nd of January 2018. So Hive knows that my data for the order is in this directory, and it will check your Hive query that you have specified the partition column also in your Hive query by the name of order date, and it will see that order date is already partitioned in Hive table. So it will directly go into this subdirectory. It will not scan all the subdirectories. It will directly go into subdirectory with the date as 2nd January 2018, and it will now get the orders from this subdirectory itself. So you have saved lot of scans among other data for other dates, because you have directly jumped into a direct subdirectory with the order date as 2nd of January 2018. So this approach is very helpful whenever you want to make your Hive queries faster based on your partition column. So whenever you are designing your table, you always keep in mind that you partition your table on columns based on which you want to write your select queries, right? So let's say I already was aware that I'll be making my Hive queries mostly or frequently on the basis of order date. So I partitioned my table on the basis of order date, and it resulted into Hive queries execution very, very faster, because I am going to save lot of scans. I'm going to avoid lot of data reading during the fetch operations. I'm directly jumping into my subdirectory and I'm reading the data. So this approach is very much used in the real-time projects, and this is the optimized way of creating your table, and you can make your Hive queries performance much, much better using partition, right? So the next thing I'm going to jump into is bucketing concept. why bucketing concept was introduced, because there was one problem in this partitioning concept also. What is that problem is, let me explain you right here before explaining you the bucketing concept. So what we have done here is that we have partitioned the data based on order date. Now you have subdirectories here, right? So now let's assume that there is some festival seasons. Let's say it's a new year, it's a festival season, or on Christmas, let's say it's a festival season, and you have many orders coming on Christmas, which is 25th of December, let's say 2018. You get a huge orders on this date, right? So you will be having a sub partition here in the end for order date as. So there will be subdirectory here for this date also, 25th of December 2018, and it will have data for all the orders placed on this particular date, right? As I said, let's assume that on this particular date the number of orders were huge, right? Let's say millions of orders were placed. So this, the data size in this subdirectory is again going to be huge, right? Because we are assuming that this was a festival season and the order date was huge for this particular partition. So there can be scenarios that you have partitioned your data for on some particular column, but still among the partition there was few partitions where the data is still huge. So some of the partitions are getting the correct data. It's not very much use. You can scan the data very well, but on some particular cases, on some particular partitions, the data is very huge. And if you select your data based on this order date as 25th of December 2018, then it's again going to take some time. It's again going to be performance hit, because whenever Hive will go to this partition with this subdirectory as 25th of December, again it will have to scan huge amount of data, right? Because in this particular date the number of orders were very high, the data volume was very high. So although that your data is segregated, although it's still a better approach if we scan the whole table versus if we scan the partition table. The partition table scan is better approach, but still there is one drawback, that if the particular partition data size is huge, again it's going to be some performance hit to an extent, right? So this problem can be solved using the bucketing concept. Now I'll jump into the bucketing concept. So let me explain you what is bucketing concept in actual. So bucketing concept, right? So as I mentioned, when you partition your data, so it creates a subdirectory. So let me write down again here, my directory was this /home/ LimeGuru/order. So this was my directory, and inside this directory I have multiple subdirectories based on the partition date. Order date equal to 01/01/2018. As another partition is order date equal to 02/01/2018. Similarly, it's still 31st of December 2018, and in between there is one date, 25th of December, where the volume, data volume was very high. 25th of December 2018, right? So let's say you want to fetch the data based on two columns. One is your order date, where order date is let's say again 25th of December 2018, and let's say you want to fetch particular categories of orders only, where the product category was, let's say, electronics, and product category was electronics, right? So as I mentioned, that whenever you are going to store the data in partition table, all the orders for 25th of December will go here, right? Now, as I mentioned, that it's going to be huge data because there were a huge number of orders placed on this date. So what will happen is that scan will happen on the complete partition. And if the data size is huge, then it's going to be a performance hit. It's going to be taking time. Now, my query was that I want to just select orders for 25th of December for particular product category, electronics, right? So all the orders are in this date, 25th of December. So it's going to scan the huge partition. It's going to scan the complete partition to fetch the orders with product category as electronics. So it's going to scan this complete partition, which is going to be slow. How can I make this faster is by the concept of bucketing. So by the concept of bucketing, I can make this type of query faster. So what bucketing does is like, so bucketing is further management of your data inside your partitions. So partitions has managed your data in a way that inside the directories, you created subdirectories using partitions. Now, if within partitions, you want to further organize your data, so that can be done by bucketing. So how bucketing will help you? In bucketing, you need to specify that how many number of buckets you want to create. Let's say I want to create 5 buckets, right? So if I have specified that I want to create 5 buckets, and you have to specify that on which column you want to do the bucketing. So in this case, I know that I am going to be querying the data inside the partitions on the basis of this column, product category. So I can define my bucketing on this column, product category, right? So during the bucketing, I need to specify two things. One is the number of buckets, and another thing is the bucket column. So in this case, I'll specify that my bucket column is product categories and the number of buckets are going to be 5. I'll tell you about a syntax also, that how you can define the bucketing in Hive queries create command, but let me explain you the concept first. So here I have specified two things, bucket column and number of buckets. So the number of buckets, so earlier my you have seen that my number of files going to be created by Hive internally, right? So inside this partition, whatever data is coming, it's going to be stored in this subdirectory. It could be any number of files here inside the order date. But if I do bucketing, what will happen in bucketing is, let's say I've defined number of buckets at 5. In that case, only 5 files are going to be created inside this partition. Other files are not going to be there. So let me remove other files. I'm just left with the 5 number of files. So what bucketing is going to do is, bucketing will create the number of files equivalent to the number you have given in number of buckets. So inside this partition, you are going to be having only 5 part files, right? So partitioning helps you in managing your subdirectories or the number of directories within your table path, and bucketing helps you managing your number of files. It will define your number of files within a particular partition. So based on the this number of files have been created, 5 files have been created, and now how the data is going to be stored is based on this column value. So my bucket column was product category. So all the orders belonging to the same value. So let's say the value is electronics. So all the orders belonging to the same value as electronics will go to the same file. I'm just giving you a hypothetical example that it's going to be first file. It could be second file also or third file also. But the thing is that all the files with the value electronics will go into the same file, right? Similarly, let's say I have another category as fashion. So all the data with product category as fashion will go into another file. So here you are managing the number of files and you are segregating the data into the files based on this bucketed column. So whenever you are going to query your data based on product category and order date, So first it will go into order date at 25th, as 25th of December. And after that, as you have mentioned that you want to get the order based on a particular category as electronics. So Hive will know that my electronics order are into the file one. So it will only scan the file one, get the orders for electronics, and it will return you the results. It will not scan other files within the partition also, right? So this is a very optimized approach that you have done the first level of segregation based on the order date, and then you have done the second level of segregation based on the product category. So you are reducing your scan to a huge extent, right? So you are not scanning the complete table. First, you are moving into subdirectory with that particular order date. Then you are jumping into the right file, directly into the file where your orders are there for that particular product category, right? So this is a nice approach to make your queries very faster, to directly jump into a particular partition and to directly jump into a particular file. So bucketing helps you in management of your files within your subdirectories or within your partitions. Many people get confused with directory and file, so I'm just telling you the difference between partitioning and bucketing. So partitioning helps you in creating the subdirectories. So these are the directories, but bucketing doesn't help you in creating the subdirectories. It helps you in creating the number of files. It helps you to define the number of files which will be created inside your subdirectory. So it's kind of a further organization of your data, right? So based on the number of buckets, it will create only those number of files which are defined in your number of buckets. So if I talk about the syntax and how you can create your Hive queries, you can write your Hive queries in a way that it is partitioned as well as bucketed also. So the syntax is like you write create table, and then you define your metadata with all the columns and their data types. And if you want to partition, you can write partition by, and then you define your column, let's say order date. You were doing the partition on order date. Partition by order date. And after that, if you want to do bucketing also, then what you write is clustered by, you define the column. This column name is product categories in my case. It could be any column name based on your own design. So product category. And then you define the number of buckets into 5 buckets. So you define the number of buckets also. So this is the syntax to write Hive queries for create table, where your table is partitioned as well as bucketed also. So partitioned by is used for partitioning your table, clustered by is used for bucketing your table. So with this approach, whenever any order is going to be inserted into the table, it will be partitioned by order date, and it will create 5 number of files for every partitions, and the data for each product category will go into the respective file within that sub partition, within that subdirectory, right? So I hope this concept is clear, that how you can make use of bucketing and partitioning to make your Hive queries faster, right? So it's going to be a very good approach to make your queries faster and to get the results instantly and to avoid the scanning of the complete data within your Hive table. I hope you like this video. Do share it with others and do not forget to subscribe LimeGuru channel to get more technical videos for your learning. Thank you.